You know what? I think I was on the inside of the FBI, and I saw the stuff. And I saw how sick people were at the things that were going on, from voucher fraud to time and attendance sheet fraud to you know, you go to court and there's a whole crew there, and one of the guys is obviously lying, and you know that they're sick about it. They're sick about it. But, sir, you know, the structure we have right now forces those people, those good people, to decide between their family security or their oath of office. And that's a dilemma we shouldn't put in their hands. They should know that when they come forward with valid, documented proof that that guy who did what he did will not be protected by his what do you call him in the Bureau, his juice man, not be protected by his management structure, will be tried in a court of law as a criminal, a serial criminal, and sent to prison. No immunity. You lied under oath. You lied under oath, you're going away. You altered evidence, you're going away. There's a man I've been tracking since 1989. That's 21 years now, sir, and collecting information on. It's well known he lied in the trial of a federal judge. Well documented. It was documented 4 years after he did it. The FBI covered it up for 9 more years. They then admitted it, but said the issue was too stale. They wouldn't revisit it. The man retired with full retirement. And 4 years, 5 years later, the FBI rehired him as a contract employee, and he's now involved in national security issues. So I'm tracking. I want to know everything about every day he ever spent in the FBI, and it's kind of fascinating. They're doing everything they can to stop us from it. I'm 62. I've probably got another 20 good years. I'm not.
So the answer is we have to pick a criminal and hound them and bring them to justice. And with the internet, we can. That's what I've always said.
Yes,
these,
sir.
If a politician.
Need, sir, you don't need to hound them. As citizens, hounding is what you need is just to collect the data. Collect the data. And as a citizen group, it is a fascinating thing. Any bit of data, by the way, I've got, I'll give away to anybody.
Well, doctor, when I say hound, I mean a hound just keeps tracking and never stops.
Yes, sir.
That's what I mean by hounding. I don't mean
an old terrapin. You just go after them. You bite onto that. You do not denigrate. You do not slander. You just collect the data. And I've got 6,000-7,000 FBI files under Freedom of Information Act now. I've only processed about 1/5 of those. And the stuff that's coming out of those files is phenomenal. You need to remember while you're doing this, just because one man lied in a trial does not make the defendant innocent or guilty. It means one man lied. And that defendant, a fellow citizen, no matter what he was accused of doing, deserves the right to a fair trial. This is America, sir. He deserves the right to a fair trial. And if the government won't give it to him, the elected government, the appointed government, then the government called the people, and we are the government of this country, can give it to him.
Absolutely. Let's shift gears for a moment. Here's the New York Times. DNA evidence can be fabricated, scientists show. They also admit that the police know how to take your prints, create a silicon copy, and plant them wherever they want.
Yes,
I've been warning the public about this for a decade. It's now becoming mainstream news. But we see the media now selling DNA as if it's 100%. They want a federal DNA database. They've been taking blood from babies for more than 30 years for a secret Pentagon database that's now been declassified. I see this as a new fraud where they can arrest you, take your blood, plant it, and then say, oh, we know you did it.
That's right. So, sir, it's not the science. It is the scientist that we must concern ourselves with. And anyone that is accused should audit that work product. And that's an extremely expensive process, extremely, to audit that work product. But, you know, this lady at the San Francisco lab had been there 29 years. I know I was in a trial, a hearing about 3-4 years ago, in which her word was overrode mine before a federal judge. And there she was, as addicted to crack cocaine, as a violent criminal with a gun, and the court accepted what she said. Well, I'm not going to let that go. You know, that thing of educating, and let's put it out in the mainstream, here's where we've won, sir. When I first joined the FBI in 1982, there was no media denigration at all of the FBI. Now, if you see a movie they're in, they're the clowns. If you know, their reputation of the FBI has been soiled by those people. by those people that crossed the blue line and tarnished their badge. It's been soiled, and the FBI didn't take care of it. So the FBI is this horrible public relations deal to overcome. But the American people know it through their culture. You know, there's a show on television called Dexter. He's a serial criminal. He works in the crime lab. Well, where do you think that idea came from? It came from, it's almost daily in the news that a crime lab has had trouble. I think we need to be careful that we don't trash every crime lab technician out there. We just need to question their work product very closely.
We need to keep them honest, and we know there's a major problem here. And it's important when you've got a big military-industrial complex owning and building more prisons, and they want to cram us all in them. It's a life-and-death situation that we point out to people that these groups can't be trusted, and we've got to keep them honest.
Why should we trust them? A scientist does not trust the work of another scientist. He always questions if that's science.
Look at Al Gore saying you cannot question the global warming hypothesis. And it turns out hundreds of universities under UN control working together in a concerted fraud.
You know, that's one of these. The kids now say, duh. I mean, I can't imagine anybody trusting Al Gore, sir. I frankly can't. I better not get started on that.
No, let's get started on it. I mean,
I'm a PhD chemist, okay? I mean, I've got a degree in chemistry besides having a law degree, okay? And I looked at what that man was doing, and I said, oh, my gosh, this is in the White House. Come on. And what a absolute buffoon he was. And we're not even describing it as buffoonery. I mean, oh, my goodness. And so what do we have? We've got this. Now we don't know whether there's global warming or not, sir. We really don't know because, you know, there's some good scientists out there that believe it, but there's some frauds out there that are pushing it like Y2K. You remember the Y2K thing?
I do remember. Stay there, Doc. Final segment with Dr. Frederick Whitehurst, also a lawyer, former FBI agent. He headed up the forensic area of the FBI crime lab.